Okay, sige. So, ituloy natin yung discussion. Okay. So, natapos tayo with the power structure. So, next natin, leadership. Ayan. So, another structural properties of the group ay yung tinatawag nating leadership. This is the ability to influence other people in some way. And leadership is a role. So, ang keyword natin for leadership is how you influence other, ano? So, more on influencing others. And meron tayong different types of theory pagdating dito sa leadership, ano? So, meron tayong tinatawag na position theory. So, leadership is based on the position that grants a person of the person the power of influence. Ayan. So, nagkakaroon ka daw ng influence, ano, halimbawa sa isang grupo, based on the position na meron ka. Ano? So, that's position theory. So, yun lang yung keyword natin doon. So, nagkakaroon ka ng influence sa taong hinahawakan mo as a leader based on the position that you have. Ano? And then we have the trait theory. Okay. So, ang palatandaan lang natin with the trait theory, so sinasabi lang ng trait theory na yung mga leaders daw ay merong mga personal traits and characteristics. So, kumbaga, inborn na sa kanila yung pagiging leader. Ano? Na ganito yung characteristic o trait ng isang leader. Ng isang leader. Okay? So, the great person theory, tinatawag din siyang the great person theory, assumes that leaders have personal traits or characteristics that make them different from other people. And then we have the style theory. Leadership is based on the style on how he influenced. So, kung paano naman siya nakaka-influensya sa ibang tao. Ano? So, iba't ibang style. So, nandyan yung ating authoritarian, democratic, and the laissez-faire. Ano? So, pag sinabi nga natin authoritarian, democratic, laissez-faire, natatandaan ba natin to? Pag authoritarian, ano yung type of leadership niya? Sige daw, marinig ko yung iba. Sino may idea between these three? Authoritarian, democratic, and laissez-faire. Yung pagkakaintindi niyo. Sige daw, magtatawag tayo. Si Charisse. Ano yung pagkakaiba ng authoritarian, democratic, at saka yung laissez-faire? Nandiyan ba si Charisse?
Hello, sir. So,
Ayan. Okay.
ang pagkakaintindi ko po sa authoritarian, sir, is yung ano po, yung authority po is nanggagaling dun sa management. Pas, pag democratic naman po, yung authority po or yung power is nanggagaling sa people. And pagka naman po laissez-faire, wala po siyang parang pinapaboran. Either yung management and also yung mga people po.
Okay. So, yan. Thank you. So, sa authoritarian, so, pag sinabi natin authoritarian leadership, ano, so, yung authority, ano, ay nanggagaling dun sa mismong leader. So, kumbaga, sa type of leadership, parang si leader ay command lang ng command. Saan nasusunod lagi, ano, that's authoritarian. Pag sinabi naman natin democratic, so ang ating keyword dito is participative style of leadership. So wherein yung mga tao ano na hinahandle mo ay nandun yung participation nila. Halimbawa sa decision making. So kumbaga hindi lang si leader yung nasusunod. Ang laissez-faire naman, medyo pag sinabi natin laissez-faire, parang hinahayaan lang ng leader, bahala kayo dyan. Ano, so kumbaga, nandun yung pagiging basta hinahayaan yung mga hinahawakan yung mga tao. Ayan. Okay, so that's style theory. So, ako na, parang kay Kurt Lewin ata ito, itong style theory, ito yung ating authoritarian, democratic, and the laissez-faire. Ayan. Sabi nga natin, authoritarian have absolute power. Ang democratic naman, so yun niya, sabi natin, is participative siya, and there is a maximum involvement and participation from all the members. Ang laissez-faire naman, leaders has minimum input. So sabi nga natin, parang hinahayaan niya lang, sige, bahala kayo dyan. Parang ganun yung term. Ano? So members are left to function and struggle by themselves. Ayan. So that's authoritarian, democratic, and laissez-faire. Ayan. So another theory po ng leadership ay yung situational theory. Situation produces leaders. Leadership is a function of the situation rather than the person or what he or she does. So pag sinabi natin situational naman, nagiging leader daw ang isang tao depende sa sitwasyon. Let's say for example, halimbawa, nagkaroon ng kalamidad, ano? So parang nagiging leader daw yung isang tao kapag ganoong mga sitwasyon, ano, kung saan medyo under pressure. So based on the situation, ano, so ayan. So nakadepende daw yung pagiging leader based on the situation. So may mga ganyang mga tao, ano, na kung saan nakikita natin pag ganitong sitwasyon ay nakikita yung pagiging leader niya. Okay? Functional leadership theory. Leadership means the performance of the acts that help the group to accomplish its goals. Distributed function approach. Ayan. So, pag sinabi natin functional leadership theory, ano, nakafocus naman siya on the functions, ano, na i-deliver na isang leader. Ayan. So, mga halimbawa nito, the group task roles, group growing and vitalizing roles, and anti-group roles. Ayan. So, another structural properties po ay yung role. So, this refers to the social recognized pattern of behavior, expectations on the part of a person in a certain position, which will help us to interpret what person is doing is or is trying to do. Ayan. So when we say role, ito yung inaasahan sa atin na gagawin. Ano? So ito ngayon tinatawag na expected to do. Ano? So on the part of a person in a certain position. Ayan. And under role, so nagtukoy dito ano ng iba't ibang role. So we have letter A, task specialist, and the social emotional or group maintenance role. So later ay matatalakay din natin yung iba't ibang roles, ano. So pag sinabi natin task specialist, ano, so more on ang function nito is to guide yung group, ano, for the achievement of the goal. Pag social emotional or group maintenance role naman, so more on ang concern nito is group harmony and more on resolving tension or conflict. So under role, meron pa tayong mga executive, ano. So pag sinabi natin executive, more on so yung top coordinator ng mga activities sa grupo. Policymaker, more on establishing policies, goals, ano, within the group. So, ang planner, more on nagde-decide naman sa ano ba yung mga pwedeng gawin, ano ba yung mga means to achieve the goals. pag sinabi naman nating expert, so usually yung mga expert, full of knowledge sila, sila yung nagiging source of information, ng skills, and etc. External group representative, so more on, ito yung mga nagiging spokesperson na mga grupo. Controller of internal relations. More on controlling naman ito ng relation or group relation between the group, ano, or between the members of the group. Purveyor of rewards and punishments, ano. So ito naman yung mga so more on pagbibigay ng mga rewards and punishment, yung nagiging task niya or role niya doon sa grupo. Arbitrator and mediator. Ito yung usually nagbibigay ng judgment, ano, conciliation pagdating doon sa grupo. Exemplar. So when you say exemplar, siya yung nagiging model of behavior within the group. And scapegoat, ano, usually ito yung nagsesegue sa group, ano, o para mailihis, ano, yung mga disappointments, mga frustrations. So kumbaga sila yung taga-ventilate ng other members of the group para mailihis from the frustrations and disappointments ang grupo. Okay, so that's role, ano. So meron pa nga tayo dito yung tinatawag na task roles and maintenance roles. Ayan. So nandyan sa task role yung information and opinion giver, information and opinion seeker, starter, direction giver, summarizer, coordinator, diagnose, reality tester, and evaluator. Sa maintenance roles naman, encourager of group participation, harmonizer and compromiser, tension reliever, communication helper, evaluator of emotional climate, standard setter and interpersonal problem solver. So pag sinabi naman natin norms, these are the rules and standards of behavior emerged in the group. So some norms are time-specific, some apply to all members, while others apply only to some. Some are strictly observed and are not. So when we say group norms, ano, so more on, pumapatungkol ito sa mga rules and standards na ipinapatupad sa loob ng grupo. So kung ang role ay tinatawag natin expected to do, ito yung inaasahang gawin mo based on your certain position na na meron ka, ang group norms naman, ito yung ought to do, yung kinakailangang gawin based on the rules and standards of the group. So dito meron tayong example, idiosyncrasy credit. So ano ba itong idiosyncrasy credit? Kind of credit for having lived up to the expectation of the group that allows them leeway in relation to the norms of the present. So pag sinabi natin idiosyncrasy credit, so kumbaga ito yung tinatawag nating immunity from punishment. So kumbaga meron daw mga minsan na members of the group na parang pinagbibigyan or entitled, ano, na hindi makasunod dun sa mga rules and standard. So kumbaga they allowed them na gawin nila yung mga non-conforming rules and standards, ano. So that's idiosyncrasy credit. Okay, so means they are free from punishment or nagkakaroon sila ng immunity from the punishment. Okay. So under group norms, we have written rules, explicitly stated norms, non-explicit informal norms, and norms beyond awareness. So pag sinabi natin written rules, ito yung mga rules na nakasulat. So let's say for example, the code of ethics. Ayan. So codified siya. Ano? Written siya. Okay. So explicitly stated norms. So these are agreed, written or unwritten. Ayan. Dito papasok yung mga explicitly stated norms, yung mga minutes of the meeting. Ayan. So sabi nga, it is agreed, written or unwritten. Non-explicit informal norms. So pag sinabi natin non-explicit informal norms, ito yung mga obvious o nakagawian na. Ano? So let's say for example, the chairperson, halimbawa magkakaroon kayo ng meeting, so kalimitan ba saan ba umuupo ang isang chairperson? So syempre lagi isang sa center of the table, ano, dun sa top of the table. Ano? So that's non-explicit informal norms of use or nakagawian na. So kumbaga hindi na kailangan i-explain pa. Ano? Kasi ito yung talaga na pra-practice. And norms beyond awareness. So, ang norms beyond awareness naman, para siyang tinatawag dun sa physics na osmosis. Kumbaga, parang nakakahawa. Halimbawa, di ba pag tayo ay, halimbawa, papasok ka sa opisina, sa school, once na nag-good morning ka, di ba, sunod-sunod na yung mag-good morning sa'yo. Good morning. Ayan. So, kumbaga, para siyang tuloy-tuloy. Ano? So, on the form of osmosis. Ano? So, greeting, good morning. So, maaring i-greet ka din ng mga taong nasa paligid mo. Okay? So, that's norms beyond awareness. Okay? So, how these norms can be changed? Ano? So, pwede daw babago through behavioral contagion, through influence on the group from the external environment, through high status members who earn idiosyncrasy credit by groups diagnosing their norms and modifying them by an outside consultant or a true group discussion by those with high esteem and who are willing to take risks. Okay. So we have status. So this refers to one's rank or standing in the group. Ayan. So it is not based on the interaction or relationship with the other group but some characteristic possess. So pag sinabi natin status, ano? So one's rank or standing in the group. So ano ba yung standing mo pagdating dun sa group mong kinabibilangan mo? Kaya nga sabi dito, more on evaluation of worth. Ano, gaano ka ba kahalaga? Ano? Doon sa grupong kinabibilangan mo. Okay? So, in short, itong role, norms, and status, pag sinabi natin role, more on expected to do, ano yung inaasahan sa atin. Norms ought to do, ano yung kinakailangan natin gawin. And then, status, evaluation of worth, so, gaano ba pinapahalagahan ng grupo yung iyong sarili? Ano? Sabi nga, is more on one's rank or standing in the group. Okay, so that's the structural properties of the group. Ano? So we have 8, ano? So nandun yung size, communication, affectional, power, leadership, the role, the norms, and the status. Ayan. Sige daw, tingnan natin. May mga sample questions tayo. So pwede po bang pakiread po ng ating question? Si Ate Eleanor, pwede pong pakibasa. Ate Mimi? Nandiyan po ba si Ate Mimi? Sige. Tulungan po na Ate Edith. Nandiyan po ba sa Ate Edith?
Yes po, sir.
Okay pa. Sige po. Pakibasa po.
These are the rules and standard of behavior emerged in the group. A, social norms.
Okay.
B, social status.
Okay.
C, social role. Letter D, social goal. Social status, sir.
Okay. Yung iba po, anong sagot natin?
Social
A.
Pwedeng i-type. A. Okay. Sa Charisse, A din. Yung iba, anong sagot nila?
A po, sir.
Okay, A. So, di ba, rules and standard. So, that's the clue. Ano, pag sinabi natin rules and standard, it pertains to social norms. Ano? So, sabi nga natin, norms are expected to do. Ito yung kinakailangan na dapat ay gawin. Ano? So, it pertains to the rules and standard. Okay, next. Sige daw, si Kim. Pakibasa nga daw, Kim.
This refers to the social recognized pattern behavior of expectations on the part of a person in a certain position which help us to interpret what person is doing or is trying to do. Social role po.
Okay, so that's social role. Ano? So letter C. Ano? So more on ano ba yung expected na inaasahan sa atin? Ano? Based on the certain position na mayroon tayo. Okay, so that's social role. Next. Sige po. Sa Ate Banji. May mic ka ba, Ate Banji? Okay. Si Jana na lang. Jana.
This refers to the arrangement or interrelation of all parts of a whole. It is a pattern developed and maintained themselves over time in interpersonal relations. Group structure po.
Okay. So yung iba, ano po ang sagot natin? Okay. Okay. So correct answer po natin ay group structure. So pag sinabi natin structure, ang tatandaan natin ay yung arrangement and interrelation of all of a whole. Ayan. So that's group structure. Okay, so yan. So punta tayo sa group process naman. Ano? So sa group process ay meron tayong anim. So kanina meron tayong group structure na walo. So dito naman ay anim. So pag sinabi natin group process, as changes in the conditions of the group as a whole. So this is a developmental sequence that groups go through. And as the interaction processes are what goes on between and among members. So our keyword for the group process, so more on the developmental sequence na nangyayari sa isang grupo. Ito yung mga changes in the conditions of the group. So more on the movement, yung pag-progress or progression of the group ang tatalakayin naman natin for this group process. Ayan. So una, sa group process, we have conformity. So pag sinabi natin conformity, yielding to group pressure. So, kumbaga nakikiayon ka, ano, base doon sa grupo na kinabibilangan mo. And we have two types of conformity. We have expedient conformer and the true conformer. So expedient, outwardly agrees but inwardly disagreed. Ayan. So kumbaga, sinasabi mo, oo, sang-ayon ako. Pero deep inside ay hindi naman talaga. So that's expedient conformer. Pag true conformer naman, conformity wherein both outwardly and inwardly agrees with the group. So outwardly and inwardly ay sumasang-ayon ka talaga. That's why tinawag sang true conformer. So number two, competition and cooperation. Ayan, so sa competition, so papasok dyan yung mga rivalry, ano, And sa cooperation naman, so more on, nandiyan na yung joint efforts, the mutual alliance ano, between the members of the group. So competitive atmosphere results when the members perceive their personal goals to be incompatible, different, conflicting, or mutually exclusive. And cooperative results when there is compatibility, similarity, or complementary in the personal goals or group members. Ayan, so that's between competition and cooperation. Okay. So, number three, decision making. Group decision making is considered as an integral step or stage in the total problem solving process. Again, so napakalaga ano, sa isang grupo daw yung pagde-decision. So group decision must be in accord to the group interaction, decision making by one or few for following reasons. So decision has to be made quickly and it cannot wait for a meeting. So ito daw yung mga reasons ano na kailangan daw agad ay madesisyonan ng agad-agad ano. The decision has to be made is not that important. So ito yung mga dahilan na kahit ko konti o kahit isa yung tao magde-decision ay pwede nang desisyonan. So precedent has been set with similar action being made previously and there was no objection from the group. So kung ang kung yung desisyonan daw naman ay the decision na rin dati, same lang din naman, and previously ay wala din naman naging objection. So pwede tayong mag-come up with the decision making. Ayan. So we have different types ng decision making. Ano? So under decision making, so meron tayong tinatawag na railroading tactics. Refers to the decision that benefits the subgroup but will be counterproductive for the whole group. Okay. So sa railroading tactics, nandito yung kumbaga pinapressure natin yung group by providing limited options ano without the benefit of analysis. So kumbaga isang taktika ng pagde-desisyon na para madesisyonan ay hindi tayo nagbibigay ng maraming options, ano, sabi nga ay limited lang yung options and hindi natin na-analyze carefully yung benefit of the analysis or we did not explain the consequences of each actions or choices. Okay? So that's railroading tactics. So under types of decision making, meron tayong voting. So sa simple majority, so ang tatandaan lang natin dito is 50% plus 1. Ano? So 50% ng grupo plus 1. So magka-come up na tayo with the simple majority. Halimbawa, 7 ano, yung ating grupo. So 50%, so mahirap pati yung 50% ano. So halimbawa ay yun nga, 6. 50% ng 6. So ID 3 plus 1. So that's a simple majority. High percentage voting naman, so nagkakaroon tayo ng pagsiset ng limit kung ilang percentage. So pag-aagrihan ng grupo. So dapat at least, halimbawa na pag-aagrihan nila, at least 75% dapat ano, yung mag-agree dun sa decision para masabi natin ito ay high percentage voting. Okay? And then sa consensus naman, so medyo time consuming siya and too much effort yung kailangan natin kapag consensus. kasi madaming pang pag-uusap dyan, isasalang-alang natin yung side nung kabila, and then isasalang-alang din natin yung side ng another kabila. Ano? So more on time-consuming at talagang maraming pag-uusap ang kinakailangan gawin. Ang postponing decisions naman, ginagawa natin if the group can agree to disagree. Ano? So, kumbaga, pinoprotect natin dito yung minority mula doon sa will ng mga majority. Ayan. So, kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng mga postponing of decisions. And delegation of decision-making authority. So, ginagamit naman natin to in order to save time. So, kumbaga, magtatalaga na tayo. Sino ba yung ating decision-making authority? It could be the leader, ano, or any members of the group, ano. Ayan. So, another process ay yung tinatawag nating groupthink. So, this refers to a problem-solving process in which proposals are accepted without careful review of their advantages and disadvantages. So, ang tandaan nyo kay groupthink, ano, from the word think, ano, kabaligtaran sa nung sinasabi nung definition niya. So, without careful review of their advantages and disadvantages, in which powerful social pressures are exerted on a group member who voices objections to what otherwise appear to be a group consensus. Okay, so that's groupthink. Next, we have conflict. So sa conflict naman, so dito papasok yung mga disagreement, mga clash between members of the group. And in conflict, so there are at least two parties involved in interaction. So this perceived or real mutually exclusive goals and or mutually exclusive values exist. Interaction is characterized by behavior intended to defeat the opponent or to gain victory. Parties face each other using opposing actions and each party attempts to gain power. Ayan. So we have types of conflict, ano? Pag sinabi natin win-lose, goal is more important than relationship. Pag naman yield-lose, relationship ay mas mahalaga kaysa sa goal. Ang loose-lived naman, they have low concern for both goal and relationship. Uncompromised style naman, win some, lose some. And integrative style, meron siyang high concern for the goals and the relationship. Okay, so that's the type of conflict. So, pang-anim, so we have group cohesiveness refers to the degree to which members of the group desire to remain in the group. This is established from motivational forces of the group. Ayan. So, under group cohesiveness, ano, so contribute to group welfare, advance the group's objective, and participate in the group's objective. So these are, ito yung ilan sa mga reasons, ano, why they remain, ano, in their group. And so ano ba yung determinants of group cohesiveness? So pag sinabi natin cohesiveness, so ang tatandaan natin, ito yung desire nila na ma-remain o manatili, ano, doon sa grupo na kanilang kinabibilangan. So, ang determinants natin, members' motive based for attraction, incentive properties of the group, expectancy concerning outcomes, and comparison level. And then, under group cohesiveness, attractiveness of group, and attractiveness of alternative membership. So ano daw ba yung mga consequences of group cohesiveness? Maintenance of the membership, power of the group over its member, participation and loyalty and personal consequences. Ayan. So ano ba yung mga nakaka-impluwensya ano doon sa group cohesiveness o yung attractiveness ano na mag-remain in the group. So syempre yung attractiveness of the members ano similarities of among members so nananatili sila since nakikita nila they are similar, they have similar problems, concerns, interests ano doon sa grupo. So syempre yung group goals na gusto nilang makamit, isa din ito sa mga nagpapanatili sa kanila sa grupo. Type of interdependence among members. The group activities, so na-enjoy nila yung mga activities ano na meron din sa grupo. The leadership and decision making, syempre. So kung nabibigyan ng bosses yung members of the group, so they remain ano, they desire to remain in the group. And then the structural properties of the group and the personal consequences. Okay. So let's try to answer. Ano? So meron tayong mga sample questions ulit. Sige po. Pakibasa po ulit. Sige, si Jana. Nandiyan ba si Jana? Okay.
This refers to a problem-solving process in which proposals are accepted without careful review or their advantages and disadvantages, in which powerful social pressures are exerted on a group member who voices objections to what otherwise appeared to be a group consensus.
Ang answer po ay?
Group think.
Okay. So the other po, baka po, anong sagot po ng iba? Pwede mag-chat? So si Charisse, letter A. Ayan. Sige, so the correct answer po natin ay syempre groupthink ano. So sabi nga natin kabaligtaran yung meaning ng groupthink ano. So without careful review of their advantages and disadvantages ano. Okay, so that's letter A. Next po. Sige. Sige po. Sino po ang pwede magbasa?
Na lang po ulit.
Okay.
This is the degree to which the members of a group desire to remain in group. Group cohesiveness po.
Ano po ang sagot ng iba? Pwede po mag-type? Mag-chat? How about the others po? Letter D, A. Okay. So the correct answer po ay letter A. So di ba pag sinabi natin cohesiveness, ito yung desire nila to remain in the group. Okay, next. Sige, Charisse.
This method wherein group can agree to disagree, it serves to protect the minority from the will of the majority. As the former is not forced to support something that violates their convictions. Letter A, consensus.
Okay, consensus. How about the others po?
I sorry, sir. Letter C pala.
Letter C. Ayan. So that's letter C. Ano? So pinaprotect natin yung will ng mga